we have to talk about inter-procedural optimization, which is called identical folding. The optimization is quite highly connected to this university because it was part of my diploma thesis, which was supervised by Kazan. So thank you for supervising and helping you with that. This optimization is mainly motivated by the fact that our applications like Firefox, Chrome, tend to produce a lot of functions which are from semantic point of view equal. So this is our motivation, and there's a quite similar stuff in the global linker which can merge functions in assembly, and yeah, that's our benchmark compared to global linker. As I mentioned, we are able to merge functions and even read-only variables. The optimization is full IPA optimization pass and is very useful in case if you enable LTO because you are able to seal functions and stuff like that. As I mentioned, our optimization works on a bit different level. More precisely, we work on Google level, and the optimization is enabled with O2 and higher and OS. The first patch was written at the end of 2013, but it was a draft. It was part of my thesis, and it took one more year to successfully merge it into GCC 5.1. It was quite hard and painful because you got a lot of issues. Because about 44 PRs, where I would say half of them were directly caused by the optimization, but on the other hand, there were some latent issues which are just exposed by the optimization. If we do a comparison with the GoLinker, the optimization in the GCC compiler is a bit different because we can influence also speed. It means that there are some special cases where we can unify functions that are potentially to be aligned by the liner, and it can bring speed improvement, or cases in from 3D. Our optimization is conservative, means that the gold linker can run in safe mode, which is equal to our optimization, and there's another option which says ICF all, which is more aggressive in the bowling curve, but it breaks some cases that I will show you. Another difference is merging of free-only variables, and it's necessary for the bowling curve to put each function into a separate section because we are able to merge as a section. Let's assume for example where we have a pair of functions that are quite simple, just returning a constant value. And let's assume we take pointers to these functions and you make a decision based on these pointers. If you use the gold linker, you pass the aggressive optimization and you have this option to show what merge operations were applied. You can see that ICF folding chose to merge function loop, function bar, and function foo, which means that if you run the binary, the written value is 1, which is wrong. So that's the difference. In the following section, I'm going to explain the algorithm. How it can be quite boring, but yeah, that's it. So at the beginning, we calculate a hash describing a function or we know a variable. Means that we hash number of basic blocks, number of arguments, little statement codes, and stuff like that. This hash value is streamed and loaded in whole program analyzers of Hilton optimization. At this time, we remove or we just have to filter out removed nodes, and we have to browse program references which can be potentially sensitive in a way of it could be addressed, or could be an interpersonal symbol. If we do that, we incrementally improve our hash value and we split all symbols to classes which are based on intuitive hash values. That's a simple example. We have three classes where we just assume basic information like number of arguments, type of input statements, and stuff like that. And we optimistically assume that all symbols in a class can be potentially merged. And yeah, that's the start point and next steps. As I mentioned, we are in whole program analysis. We have some information about type of functions, type of arguments, and stuff like that. So we just can improve our hash value without loading the body of function. Doing so, we can subdivide our classes, and we can process Cauldron's reduction algorithm, which was described and maybe it's used in optimistic value numbering. It's our Cauldron from the 90s. And if I come back to my slide, it just splits classes according to edges. Means that if we assume all edges coming from the symbols, these two edges are coming to a different class B, while these two are pointing to the same class, so that we just split this class to two subclasses. If we do that, we can, so we subdivide it, and when we are finished, we can just tell that all symbols in a class are equal. So we just pick first symbol and the rest of members of the class can be merged. How we merge? In case of variables, there's just a single option. If the target supports addressing, we create a class. And that's the only case. We have to be careful about address taking, discardable, and conditional stuff like that. In case of functions, it's more interesting because you can either take LSing, or if nothing is not possible, you can create a wrapper. We do utilize time expansion, means that we just remove the original body, we create a new edge, and we tell expander to create a time. And the last option is creation of redirections, where we can locally redirect functions if these functions are local and stuff like that. So it's quite complex. In the following section, I will show you how we compare pair of functions based on gimbal base. So that's a simple example where we have two functions, different identifier, made it with tree or basic blocks, and we compare each GMO state and see these blocks. So, in the first example, I will show how we compare tags. So, we take all tags, function, and return type, and we build, we basically build mapping. We build mapping for declarations, say names, and basic blocks, and stuff like that. So, it's the whole idea of just building mapping and using this mapping. So, tags, match. Second example shows how we compare people's statements. In this case, it's simple assignment. There we have addition, which is equal, and we have three operands which are added to the mapping. And as you can see, there's more speed. Declaration and just watch the default definition of this name. It's this one, and we do mapping. So it's quite simple. There are many comparisons. Second example shows how we compare fields. So in this case, there are cities, people. This one is constant, matches, and we also compare this edge. So this edge is coming from basic block 2, which should match basic block and the second function. So that's the description, how it works. This is version of Google, where we create a wrapper, as you can see. There's a call to the second function. We just copy arguments. And as you can see, it's a tail call because of its returning the value. And yeah, so it's just a single statement. If you watch assembly, there's really jump to the merge function. So, results. It's probably the most interesting part of my talk because, as I mentioned, we are mainly interested in large applications like Firefox, which is about 90 million lines of code, which are separated to 10,000 header files and source code files. In home programming devices, you can see a quarter of a million functions or precisely symbols. And our optimization can just take 5 seconds, which is about 5% of programming devices. So I hope it's quite reasonable time for chain optimization. Following table shows size of binary. That comes from readup, where I removed debug info and strip to the binary. Field section is dot text. There's a data section, dynamic allocation, exception handling, and this is total amount size needed for the binary. If you pick up GCC part 1 and you disable our optimization, it's about 8 megabytes. With the optimization, we save some space, which is about 2.5%. If you do the same, like disabling our ICF and enable the gold linker with save mode, you can get to these numbers, which are quite conservative. This branch is a bit more aggressive in the case of comparing address references and data stuff like that. This can give us about 3.2 person, 3.2 person improvement. What I did, I tried to combine this mode with say mode of the gold linker, and it shows that there's no big improvement. The improvement is still quite small, is to receive if you change same mode to legacy mode.
The numbers are mixing variables and functions together.
That's a good
Yeah, I added the flag which is called semantic interposition, and you can control it. And it adds a couple of percent, but well, I think it's not the Firefox, it doesn't do 8%.
Well,
I didn't try Chrome because it's too difficult for me to build. But yeah, there is a flag, so it's easy to try it, especially for Martin.
Yeah,
yeah, that would be interesting to see, yeah.
This is the actual histogram of symbols in classes, saying that how many persons of symbols live in a class with one member, which is at the beginning of the IPA class. It's about 7 person, and during the time as we are subdividing these classes, we end up with about 80% of symbols that are in a class with just one symbol. So these classes can be basically ignored because it's impossible to merge symbols the same one. And the rest are candidates for unifying. So quite surprising that we even have classes with a huge number of functions. When I tried to look at it, it was the kind of constructors.
Actually, I was debugging one case in the Chrome, which was, the number was even bigger, it was something like 40,000, and it was the constructor which was always brought local by SRA. So IPA SRA has turned the COM data into the local function, and we ended up with zillions of copies of this local function because we decided to not inline it because all the calls was called. Yeah, it was small, but it was still 10,000 copies of 5 stars, you know.
Okay. So, which work? Another similar class and system compiler is tree-ssa-tail-merge, which basically tries to merge basic blocks using proving that these basic blocks are equal. I sent a patch to MemoList a month ago, which is capable to replace original data memory usage with ICF engine. I would expect it to be merged very soon according to the feedback I was given. Second example was mentioned yesterday by Uza. It's a function called Inter-producedural, which is very, very similar to function which is used in
function and so the length population Expect the gimbal to be identical, but the assembler to be different. I'm thinking of like IFUNC functions where you compile, let's say, the same source function multiple times for different architectures, and you're going to use IFUNC to choose at runtime which one you're going to execute. If they're identical like people, it looks like you'll merge them.
So you're thinking about functions that are equal on the GIMP level, but different on
the GIMP. At the assembler level, yeah.
I assume he needs the target attributes.
Yeah, so yeah, it's like you have multiple bent copies or string functions, and you want to compile one for, in our case, for power, one for power 8, because it's going to run power 8, that's not power 8, one for power 7.
And
so
you're going to get to
the GIMP looks the same.
You compare target attributes, so they don't equal. We do not merge.
Pardon me? No, I mean, the source, you can have the same, like an iPhone function, you can have multiple versions of a function. The name is slightly different, but the function is of what they're doing is the same, but we're going to generate different assembly for different CPUs that we're going to be
using.
Actually, the split part of the function would match with something which is not split, and that's why you get the mismatch. So that's definitely something which can be fixed, but yeah, needs a little bit of care.
That's it. Thank you for attention.